Hi, in this video I will talk about masking. And masking is a way to very conveniently access specific parts of an array. So first we create an array using arrange, and then we want to create this mask. And we want to create a Boolean mask, and this is why we create this list of Booleans which has the same shape as our array here. So we have five Boolean values. And then we just turn it into a NumPy array using the np.array function. And now we want to access all the elements of R, so the array, where the mask is true. And for that, we can just use the square bracket syntax and put in the mask. And this will give us 1, 3, and 5. And you can see here that these were the first, the third, and the last value, because these are the only ones that are true. All right, and it's very convenient because NumPy already returns us these Boolean arrays if we use Boolean operators on arrays. And so for example here, if we ask for the values which, with array less than 10, this will return a Boolean array with Booleans indicating where elements are less than 10 and where they are greater or equal to 10. So if there was a fault in there, that element would be larger or equal than 10. And yeah, we can use that mask, which was generated by this Boolean operator, to now access this array. And in this case, this doesn't do anything. But for example, if we ask for the array where the array values are less than 3, then we just get 1 and 2, because all of the other values are larger than 3. Or equal 3. All right, and yeah, now there will be an exercise, and if you want, you can pause the video and try to figure out what you would have to write to replace all the numbers in this array up here, this one. So you would, what you would have to write to replace all the odd numbers in the array with -1. All right, and I will show you now. So what we would have to do is use the indexing. And then just set the array values where the array modulo 2 equals 1. And if we execute this, we'll just get the values. So these are all the odd numbers in the array. And then we can just use this to set them to -1. So this will not print anything because this doesn't return anything, this statement. But then if we display array, we can see that all the odd values have been replaced by -1.